Yeah, here we are. We are safe and well after quite a few hot days. And today, this Sunday, is to recuperate. So Vito says his ambient music is the best. So that's what we're going to be playing for you. We won't be dancing. No, we'll take it easy. So, Vito, I can hear the music, Vito. You can't hear the birds? Yeah, so what are you looking for? I think Vito is wondering if you can hear the birds. So I'll talk to you a little bit while he's figuring it out. So we received a word this month from a gentleman who lives in Toronto, Canada. And he was mentioning how wonderful and how inspiring it is to have his generation represented at the Lot Radio. And there are, of course, a lot of us baby boomers. We're certainly very happy to be with you, all of different generations, the silent one, the millennials, the X, the Z, the Alpha, once a month. And it's a lot of fun to be there with you. So we need to thank François Vaxelaire, who's the creator of the Lot Radio. And one day he asked us to take this two-hour show on Sundays, once a month. And there we are. Here we've been. So I think this is not it. So he says. So let's go to Long Island, the Hamptons. It's recorded live one summer, some time ago. Thank you. So great to hear the sea like this, huh? On a sunny Sunday morning here in New York, anyway. With finally cool temperature. So from Long Island, we're going to hear the Flux Quartet playing a string quartet that Vito wrote. I think it's around his mom's death. And it's called Don't Know Who I Am. Let's listen to it.
Thank you.
It's Sunday morning in New York City. Beautiful, beautiful day. We decided today, no dance music. Let's relax and get on wherever you're going to go today. You may have left already. Maybe you're in the car. I don't know. This was the Flux Quartet playing a string quartet, Vito Ricci's string quartet. We are going now to Ice Station Zebra. I don't know if you have any idea what this is. I didn't. So Vito played me this ambient soundtrack that he wrote for a play, a theater piece by Susan Mazakowski some time ago. And so I just needed to know what Ice Station Zebra was. It seemed quite important. So first of all, there was an English thriller novel by British writer Alistair MacLean published in 1960. But this was influenced by the heightened atmosphere of the Cold War in the late 50s and early 60s. High-tech machinery that was built on an ice floe in the Arctic Sea. So you can now imagine whatever you want. Let's go to the Arctic Sea in this Ice Station Zebra with Vito Ricci.
Thank you.
That was Ice. Ice from Ice Station Zebra, a play, theater play, written by Susan Wozakowski. Vito had written the music for this, or composed the music. So we needed a little bit of ice this week. So now we've got the fresh air in New York, anyway, in New York City. And we're going for Raindrop, so no rain in sight, and we're very happy. But we'll go with this haiku, that very, very short haiku that Vito wrote over some Yuko Otomo's short poem. Of course, you know that a haiku is very short. And then we'll hear Raindrop music in my ears, which is a really a wonderful ambient piece again. So let's do that. Let's go on. Raindrops. One and two become one. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, rain dropping music in our ears. It's been a wonderful time with you all, young and old. We are going to be here on August 27th again. And meanwhile, I say adios, hasta el próximo mes, a bientôt, with you soon. Enjoy the day.